listening to the What the Wrestling Podcast, the show that brings you all things wrestling with your host, RJD.
Perfect. Monday Night Raw took place last night. They're trying. I'll give them that. I will give them an A for effort. That's all I'm giving them, though.
Nope.
But it's better than SmackDown, so I'm not going to sit here and complain. No, I am not.
You stupid.
With that being said, check out my socials. As always, follow me, RJD, RJD10K on Instagram, RJ699 on Twitter, RJD199 on Snapchat. Most importantly, follow What the Wrestling on Facebook, YouTube, and TikTok.
Perfect.
And with that being said, let's go. Yes, 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 tis I, RJD here. Welcome to What the Wrestling, home of all things wrestling. For the fourth time, I am your host, RJD, here. And yes, we are going to get into this review, but before we do, don't forget to hit the like button, like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel. What the Wrestling.
You've activated my trap card.
Just do it, goddammit. Just do it.
Do it! Just do it!
With that being said, Monday Night Raw, they're trying. Listen, I give them an A for effort, okay? They're trying. SmackDown is bad. Monday Night Raw is not as bad. But listen, we gotta do better, okay? We gotta do better, okay? We have to do better. They're better than this. But what I will say is this storyline with Seth Rollins. We all know where this is going. We all know where this is headed. We all know where this ends. But WWE is dragging it out. So we're going to drag it out right along with them.
You stupid.
But we're going to be all right. We're going to get this done. We're going to get this done. So I'm going to bounce around here because, like I said, this show didn't really have much on it, but the best thing on the show was by far Seth Rollins. So this was a, before I get to KO and all that, because he started the show, Seth Rollins, he came out, he interrupted the first actual match we saw. He came out saying, listen, they interviewed him backstage. He said, listen, I need a match, okay? And I'm going to get my match. He came out. He went on the microphone, reminiscent of what he did in NXT about 3-4 years ago when he fought Triple H. And he came out on TakeOver. He was like, this is TakeOver, right? Well, I'm taking this bitch over. And they built up to him and Triple H. I think it was WrestleMania, if I'm not mistaken. He came out during matches. He was in the back. He was just all goddamn show long. He just came and interrupting everybody, saying he wants his match. The crowd repeatedly were giving Cody chants. Cody, Cody. And he acknowledged him briefly. He said, listen, rumors are nice, but he addressed them by saying something about rumors, how it's nice to have rumors, but I need something concrete or something along the lines of that. So the crowd is not stupid.
stupid.
We see what's going on here. We know what's coming. So, comes out during a match, during the Mysterios and Dolph Ziggler match. They cut him off. It was kind of awkward. It was kind of weird coming across on TV. Like, I knew what it was about, but it was kind of weird because he was talking. Then they cut his mic. Then they didn't cut his mic. It was just a weird-ass segment. Sonya Deville and Adam Pearce saying, listen, they meet later to talk about it. He came out and interrupted AJ Styles while he was cutting a promo on Edge. And that culminated in a match at the end of the night. It was actually a damn good match. It was really good. It was really good. It got some time, which is good, which is always a good thing. Two excellent professional wrestlers doing what they do best. But the end came when, and basically the winner was going to fight Edge. So Seth Rollins said, listen, I'm desperate, baby, and desperate. And I'm running out of chances here. So,
stupid.
AJ says, fine, whatever. So, I think they advised against it, Adam Pearce and Sonya. But he said, you know, I'll do it myself. He went out there and Thanos'd it. So, he went out there. They were having a good match. He was setting up for the phenomenal forearm towards the end. And he gets hit in the back with a steel chair by Edge. You see, no one asked Edge who Edge wants to fight at WrestleMania.
Stupid.
So because of that, AJ Styles got hit with the chair, so he is the de facto winner. So he fights AJ Styles at WrestleMania, and Seth Rollins is going around telling everybody how it's bullshit. And they tried to fake bleep out the word shite, but they did a piss poor job of it.
Stupid.
I'm going to be hitting that button a lot today, as you can see. So they tried, and that was that, so... Seth Rollins still doesn't have a match. And he said, I don't know what's going to happen. He said next week. if he doesn't get his match, then Raw does not take place. I'm really looking forward to seeing how that shapes up. Is he going to just, you know, snap away Monday Night Raw? I don't know. But he said if it doesn't happen, if he doesn't get what he wants, it doesn't take place. Cool with me. We'll see what happens. So, either they're going to debut Cody, and then next week is WrestleMania, or Cody will make, they'll have a graphic. They'll have a graphic of some sort, and then Cody will appear on the graphic. I don't know. It depends on what they want to do. I would not debut Cody until WrestleMania. I would just have Seth Rollins come out during WrestleMania, and I would just have Cody interrupt him. And then, well, this is WrestleMania. You're not going to give me my moment. Well, I'm going to take my moment. And he comes out in the middle of the show, and then they set up that match for night two of WrestleMania. That's what I would do. Just have him debut in front of everybody. Have him go crazy. He's going to get a crazy good pop. Because the crowd is going to make him a de facto babyface because he's coming back to WWE. That's what I would do. So, you may or may not get Cody next week, but you're definitely getting Cody at WrestleMania. So, for all you guys who said Cody's coming,
give me a hell yeah.
Good stuff, because he's coming. So, with that being said, this was the best thing on the entire show. It was like a storyline, show-wide events. It was great. I liked it. Cool. We had Mr. Hell Yeah himself.
Give me a hell yeah.
He started off the show, got a crazy big pop, but it was just Kevin Owens in a ball cap letting everybody get mad, and then he came out.
How dare you?
And the crowd was tight. It was like, gotcha, bitch. Everybody was upset. Oh, it was lovely. So he came out. He did the fake beer spot where he tried to catch some beers, but he missed them all. He fake drank. The geek who was throwing him beers told him to get in the ring and hand him the beer. He did so, gave him a stunner. Fake cracked the beers together, was going to drink it, but he poured it out on the guy. Kevin Owens is great. Heel, babyface, doesn't matter. This started the show. And this was good. I like this. This was good. Good stuff here.
Respect my authority.
Next, we had the Mysterios versus Dolph Ziggler and Robert Roode. The Mysterios get the win from a frog splash by Dominic onto Robert Roode. You're not going to pin the NXT champion, are you?
Respect my authority.
About goddamn time they did something right with their champions. But it's all good. Robert Roode eats the pin. But it's all good because this wasn't too bad. Nice, decent little match. Like I said, Seth Rollins came in and interrupted this. But it was weird. Went to commercial break. Came back. Match continued. All good. We had Omos beating Commander Aziz and Apollo. They look real soft. They look real soft in this. So, to those guys. Omos is being built up crazy. I was thinking Bobby Lashley would come and beat him. But Omos is just going to start running through cats, I believe. But he's still not ready. Still not ready. We have Natalya and Shayna Baszler fighting Rhea Ripley and Liv Morgan. Natalya and Shayna Baszler getting the win here. Shayna Baszler beat Morgan with the heart attack. After the match, the women's tag team champions, Zelina and Carmella, attacked both teams. They were on the same page, then not on the same page. Queen Zelina was getting mad. She was just like,
how dare you?
Tighten up, goddammit. They're coming for our tag team titles, which don't really mean anything, but tighten up. And they ended up standing tall at the end of this, which makes me think they will not be keeping those belts. Becky Lynch, she cut a promo saying that she would sell her soul for the WWE Championship. And she's at the top of her game, and she's going to prove it once again at WrestleMania. Decent promo by Becky here. We have Finn Balor beating Austin Theory via roll-up when Pat McAfee distracted the ref, then distracted Austin Theory. Then because of the distraction, Austin Theory tried to hit his finisher but got rolled up in the process. Sucks to be you. Wait. Stupid.
Wait. You stupid.
Then we had RK Bro beating Alpha Academy. Riddle hit Chad Gable with the Bro Derek. After the match, Otis took out both members of the RK Bro before the Street Profits came down for the save. But they turned the tide on Riddle as well, taking him out as Randy Orton was still down on the outside. So the Street Profits are like, F that. We're going for the gold. And listen, that was your Monday Night Raw, all right? It was decent. They tried. SmackDown, they tried. But the problem here is that it's too many rematches. Thus is the problem every single week with this goddamn show and SmackDown. Rematch after rematch after rematch. We're tired of seeing 51 gazillion gamillion rematches. That sucks.
You stupid.
So they got to do a better job of surprising us.
Surprise, motherfucker.
With something other than the same shit we've seen for 8 weeks. So let's see what happens moving forward. WrestleMania a couple of weeks away. I'm looking forward to the go home show. I'm looking forward to the stuff they're doing with Cody. Let's keep the ball rolling. Cody will be there eventually. When? We'll see. But at least they're starting off on the right foot. With that being said, I'm out of here. NXT tonight. Let's see if NXT 2.0 is any better. I hope that Dolph Ziggler continues to do some new shit, and hopefully he makes us care about what's going on. But we'll see what happens. But normally after NXT,
fuck this shit, I'm out.
It's been putting me to sleep. So I will see you guys mañana. I am out of here. You guys be safe. It's All She Wrote. Follow me, as always, hit that like button, like, comment, share, and subscribe to the channel, and we will see what happens tomorrow as I bring you the NXT review with the news. Peace.
Emotional.